Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. Blessed be God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
All ye faithful, joyful and
of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. Tremble before him all the earth. Say among the nations,
the Lord reigns.
Then Isaiah said, therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Our everlasting Father, we have gathered here on this joy-filled evening to celebrate the birthday of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. Fill our hearts with the joy that comes only through the Spirit, working his grace within us. With humble and repentant hearts, we kneel in spirit before the manger to see our Savior this holy night. Fill our hearts with the shepherd's joy and the angel's praise as we gaze on him in faith. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Let us hear the gospel of the Lord on this Christmas Eve, Luke chapter 2, beginning with verses 1 through 5.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census would be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census to take place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone in his went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
St. Luke chapter 2, verses 6 through 7.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
And before we sing,
This is the time when we take these out. And I'm going to call for the lights, and everybody get ready for this as we sing Silent Night. Go. Chapter 2, verses 8 through 14.
Whew. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests."
Thank you.
chapter 2, verses 15 through 20.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
This is the moment that I feared all year. I'd like to invite the children to come up to, let's talk about the Christmas story. If you can't see, come up here. Are we ready? Can you see it? Can everybody see? If somebody can't see, you can come up here. But I have brought my Christmas box. And you know what's in my Christmas box? No gifts. Yeah, I guess you're right. I guess it is a gift. But I've got, here we go. The Christmas box that I bring has certain individuals in it. You got to sit down. First of all, we have
Mary.
Mary, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Remember, the Christmas story involves Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus and shepherds and angels and anybody else? Cattle, a cow, and a donkey, and a sheep, and a shepherd. Those are the ones. So here you've got, this is, she doesn't look like a shepherd, and she doesn't look like Joseph. So it must be, got it. You guys are smart group. And then you have also, Mary was in a town called Nazareth when an angel came down to visit her and told her, said, Mary, you're going to have a special baby, and that baby is going to be
Jesus.
That's right. And so then the angel went and told another guy,
Joseph.
All right. There, and told Joseph, don't be afraid to marry Mary. And you'll be Mary if you marry Mary. And so, because she's going to have a baby, and it's going to be
Jesus.
All right. And so you've got that. And so the angel went away from them. And then they went down to Bethlehem, and maybe Mary rode on a
donkey.
What kind of a sound does a donkey make? All right, then they got down to Bethlehem, and lo and behold, the only place that was open to them was a barn, a stable, and it probably had
a cow.
What kind of a sound does a cow make? Okay, it might have had a cow in it. And then while she was there, Joseph almost passed out because she started to have a baby, and she had the baby
Jesus.
That's right. And so she had the baby Jesus, and they were just overwhelmed with all that was taking place. And the cow said, and the donkey said, but it just wasn't quite enough. And so the angel going around saying, who can I tell? Who can I tell? And so the angel came upon a group of
shepherds
and said to the shepherd, have I got good news for you? For unto you is born this day in the city of David, which is Bethlehem, a baby which is Christ the Lord, and this shall be a sign to you. You'll find the baby wrapped in
cloths,
swaddling cloths, lying in a And so they went and quickly, and they probably took some of their sheep, and the sheep said,
all the way through.
And when they got there, they all rejoiced that Jesus, it was his birthday once again. And that's what we're doing tonight too. We're rejoicing with Jesus as he celebrates his birthday. We celebrate it too. But now you've got to help me out here a little bit, okay? Because we've got to tell everybody this news. I'm going to put these all back in here, and I'm going to say, if I was a brown cow, I'd moo real loud and clear. Moo, moo, moo. Let's try that again. If I was a brown cow, I'd moo real loud and clear.
Moo.
Well, what was that last moo?
Moo.
Let's try three moos. You got to go three moos. If I was a brown cow, I'd moo real loud and clear. And wish the baby Jesus a birthday of good cheer. If I was a donkey, I'd hee-haw loud and long. And I'd tell the baby Jesus, that's my birthday song. If I was a fluffy sheep, I'd baa baa loud and long. And tell the baby Jesus that I'd cuddle to him real near. And now, if I was an angel, I'd flap my wings and sing. How do you flap your wings? Flap, you gotta go through, flap, 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 flap. And then you gotta sing, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
gloria,
gloria,
in ex,
celsius,
deo,
deo.
Guys are so good. If I were a shepherd, I'd yell out, hip, hip, hooray! And I, three times, hip, hip, hooray!
Hip, hip, hooray!
Hip, hip, hooray!
and tell the baby Jesus that it's his birthday. So now, you know exactly what everybody did back then to celebrate Jesus' birthday. What are you going to do? Anybody getting any presents this year? Whoa. Do you know what the present stands for? Every time you have a present, you remember the greatest present that you ever received, and that greatest present is
Jesus.
That's right. Now I'm going to close up my Christmas box, and I want to direct you over to the Christmas trees or wherever they might have them. The vicar on one side and Pastor Meyer on the other, because I have something special for you. It's a rose. Look at this. And when you open it up, you have Mary and Joseph and little Jesus too, the cow and the donkey. That's more than two. So when you take this rose, you remember that the rose is blooming and it's Jesus, and it blooms in our heart as well as we celebrate Jesus' birthday. So this is for you to take. So, all right. So everybody, let's have a word of prayer, and then we can go over to the Christmas trees. Or the vicar's over there too, you guys, if you're sitting on that side. All right. Dear Jesus, happy birthday. Thank you for coming as a baby to save us from our sins. Thank you, Jesus. And happy birthday. Hip, hip, hooray. Gloria in excelsis. Amen. All right. Thank you guys for coming up.
I have one question.
The donkey's name is the donkey. We're not doing that. I'd like to invite the ushers to take up the offering. If you have a newborn or a baby, and this is their first Christmas especially, be sure and pick one of these up for them as well, just as a reminder and a remembrance of this first Christmas for them. friends, as we are preparing also, not only for Jesus coming in humility 2,000 plus years ago, but we also prepare for his coming through the body and the blood that he offers to us in earthly elements of bread and wine. It's imperative that then we then receive this with a repentant heart, and that we also receive it believing that our sins are forgiven by him, and that we receive his true body and true blood with this holy eating and drinking. So I ask you, in confessing our sins to God, why did the Christ child come? Why did the Christ child come? He came to die.
He came to die.
Look at his bed, a manger rough and crude, so unprepared for the King of Kings, for the Savior of the world. Now look at your heart. Is it ready to receive him? Heavenly Father, I am a sinner by nature and by choice. I deserve nothing from you but punishment. Yet in your great mercy, you sent Jesus to be my Savior. Forgive me and renew me through your Spirit. Amen. Christ came for you. In him is the love of God displayed at its fullest. And this is love, the scripture tells us, not that we love God, but that he loved us and gave his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sin. You are to give him the name Jesus, the angel said, because he will save his people from their sins, and we are those people. I have good news for you. Your sins are forgiven you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's sing.
Hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have given us a new revelation of your glory, that seeing you in the person of your Son, we may be drawn to the love of those things which are not seen. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and singing. We praise and thank you for having had mercy on those whom you created, sending your only begotten Son into our flesh as the Christ child of Bethlehem to bear our sin and to be our Savior. With repentant joy, we receive the salvation accomplished for us by the all-availing sacrifice of his body and blood on the cross. Gathered in the name and the remembrance of Jesus, we beg you, O Lord, to forgive, renew, and strengthen us with your word and spirit. Grant us faithfully to eat his body and drink his blood as he bids us to do in his own covenant. Hear us as we pray in his name and as he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body of the new covenant, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he blessed it and gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." To you, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory in your holy church, forever and ever. Amen. Christ shall die. Christ is risen. Christ shall come again. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Thank you. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, love and religion never end, child. Heaven above, heaven.
This holy eating and drinking strengthen you and keep you in the true faith until life everlasting. Amen. Let's stand for our closing prayer and blessing. We pray. Gracious Lord and Savior, we have heard again your word of grace. We have tasted your goodness in Holy Communion and received that uplifting assurance that our sins have been forgiven, and that we have the strength of your grace to live a holier life. Bless us as we go out from here, that we might, like the shepherds, glorify and praise you through our daily life and spread the word about this child, this Savior, our Savior, Christ the Lord. Amen. May the Christ child of Bethlehem be your Christ and your Lord, your Savior and your King, blessing you with his grace, his joy, and his everlasting peace. The Lord who promised Christmas, bless you and keep you. The Lord who made Christmas a reality, smile on you and be gracious to you. The Lord who is Christmas, look upon you with favor and grant you his Christmas peace tonight, each day, and always, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.